Sup guys, Mercabes here. And today we'll be checking out the brand new MonsGeek M2, a follow-up from MonsGeek's first board, the MonsGeek M1. But before anything else, MonsGeek did send this board out for an honest review. But as usual, that won't affect this review in any way. I wasn't paid to say anything specific about the product, so all thoughts and opinions are always my own. They're seeing this video at the same time you guys are. With that out of the way, now onto the review. So the board is available directly from MonsGeek's website, priced at $109.99 for the black and silver variants and $115.99 for the lilac purple variant. For viewers in the Philippines, the board is also available from Shopee starting at $6,200 for the black and silver variants and $6,400 for the lilac purple variant. The unit that I have on hand is the silver variant, which is actually a new colorway that MonsGeek offers with their boards to replace their now discontinued e-white colorway. Anyway, the unboxing experience is pretty much the same thing you get with the M1. Opening up the box, you'll get a rubberized coiled USB-C to A cable, the included sticker sheet for tape modding, ACO screw and stabilizers, extra screws with a hex key, and finally the user manual. Taking the board out of its dust cover and PE foam wrap, we can check out the board itself. The first thing you'll notice is that it shares the same design language as the M1. A clean, boxy, industrial look with nice chamfered edges all around. I don't have a scale handy to check, but trust me when I say this board is one of the heaviest I've ever held for a board without an internal or external weight. The sheer mass of the board is really just the board being built like a tank. This thing is never gonna budge on your desk. So the board layout is called an 1800 layout or 96%, meaning it's a more compact alternative to a standard full-sized layout keyboard. So for those of you that want to have a numpad handy at all times, you're pretty much covered. On the back of the board, you'll find the USB-C port located on the left side. And on the bottom, you get 4 rubber feet, an embossed MonsGeek logo, and a sticker with a serial number on it. You should also start seeing this design on the back of newer produced MonsGeek M1 silver units. Now for the teardown. To open up the board, there are a total of 10 hex screws, 5 at the top and 5 at the bottom. Careful lifting up the PCB and plate assembly, because the board does use a daughter board, just like the M1, so disconnect the JST connector carefully. The plate assembly is gasket mounted, so you'll find these silicone gasket jackets all around the plate. You can take the plate assembly apart by unscrewing a few screws under the PCB for the plate standoffs. The main plate assembly comes with IX-PE foam, plate foam, and a polycarbonate plate. Extra plates should be available for purchase from MonsGeek, like FR4, POM, and aluminum. The PCB supports 5-pin switches, uses Kale hot swap sockets with south-facing LEDs, and is QMK and VIA compatible, letting you remap keys and commands on the board however you like. Taking a look at the bottom case, there are these removable gold side accent pieces. MonsGeek has confirmed that there'll be different colors available for purchase at a later date, in case you want to switch up from the gold, though you could also just change the design with some decorative tape. Next, you get some bottom case foams, a thick foam and a much thinner foam similar to packing foam. And underneath, you get a protective film to keep the PCB from making contact with the bottom case and shorting. Then finally, you have the daughter board with the JST connector. Now for the build. I'll start out by lubing all the included ACO screw-in stabilizers with Krytox 205 Grade 0 and installing them onto the PCB. Then for switches, ACO sent over some of their new ACO Snow Blue Gray Linear switches. These are ACO's first 5-pin switch. They have a 43-gram actuation, bottom out at 50 grams, and are made of a nylon bottom, PC top, and long pole palm stem. Out of the box, they're bone dry without any factory lube and are kind of a no-go for me personally. So for this video, I tub lube the stems with Krytox 205 Grade 0 and bag lube the springs with 105 oil. After that, they felt nice and smooth. Then I'll be installing the included tape mod, of course making sure to leave a cutout for the JST connector, and then putting everything back together. The included tape mod doesn't seem to allow the case to close properly if you use both of the included case foams, so you'll need to use only one layer if you plan on using any of them. And finally for keycaps, I'll be using a set of Osamu Keys Winter Glow Eve for this build, since I think these caps pair really nicely with the color of the snow blue-gray switches, plus the silver case. A pretty minimalist and cozy looking build. These keycaps are Dysub PBT with a 1.6mm thickness, making for a thockier sound profile. Now that the build's done, I'll let you guys listen to the typing test. Okay, so one thing that bothered me immediately was how pingy the board sounded in keys around the corners of the board, like on the backspace, enter, and right shift key. So I'm gonna remedy that with the Force Break mod. So what the Force Break mod does is it stops harsh contact between the top and bottom case, creating that harsh pinging sound. The board does come with stabilizer pads in the box, so I'll be using those to help out with this. I'm basically gonna be installing them all around the bottom case and cushioning points where the top and bottom case meet. In theory, this should help address all the pinginess by adding a cushioned layer between the metal and metal contact. Next thing to work on was the included case foam. It didn't really give any room for the board to flex whatsoever, so I'll be taking that out and changing out the included tape mod for two layers of masking tape instead. This should give the plate assembly a lot more room to bounce around and flex. Now here's a typing test of the board after those simple mods. Okay, so overall, a pretty good improvement from the original config. The Force Break mod seems to be pretty essential for this board. Otherwise, the corner keys would just ping like crazy. The removal of the case foam also gave the board a lot more room to flex, without changing the sound signature too much. I'm pretty happy with how this build turned out. It feels great, sounds great, and looks really minimalist. Now, where does this board sit compared to other available 1800 layout boards? Honestly, there's only one company that's really pushing boards like this at a close enough price point, and that's Keychron. Keychron has their Q5 and V5 boards, and I really feel that this M2 from Monsgeek has them beat, hands down. At just $110 versus $175 for the Barebones Q5 and $89 for the Barebones V5, I'd strongly recommend just picking up this M2. You get a much softer polycarbonate plate instead of a stiff steel plate on the Keychrons. Plus, you have your choice of other plate options should you choose to order aftermarket ones from Monsgeek. You pretty much get all the same functionality as the Q5, but at a more affordable price. It's kind of crazy that Monsgeek can offer something with this premium of a feeling at such an affordable price. It's really impressive. So yeah, this board gets a big thumbs up from me. If you're an office worker that wants to use a custom keyboard at work but can't ditch the numpad, or someone that likes having a numpad around for macro keys, this should definitely be on your list. Just like with the M1, the only hurdle you'll really run into is having to lube and tune your own stabilizers. But like I said in that review, it really isn't that big of a problem, and picking up how-to isn't that hard. So that's pretty much all I've got to say about the board. Monsgeek is killing it in the budget segment, and I'm looking forward to what else they've got in store. Alright, that's it for this video. If you enjoyed the video, please feel free to leave a like, subscribe if you haven't already, and leave a comment if you have any questions. All relevant links will be in the video description. Till next time, Merkeebs out.